Welcome back on the class of introduction to solid mechanics. So I hope you all are safe and doing well. So in the previous discussion we have seen how to compute the hoop stress, longitudinal stress and radial stress in thin cylinder, and after that I have discussed about the thin sphere. In thin sphere I have discussed the magnitude of longitudinal stress and hoop stress is exactly equal, and the magnitude is PD by 4T. After that you have computed the hoop stress, hoop strain and longitudinal strain, and the hoop strain and longitudinal strain is same in terms of Poisson's ratio, internal fluid pressure, thickness and diameter. And after that I have computed the volumetric strain, and in thin sphere volumetric strain is 3 times the hoop strain. Today I am going to discuss about the thick cylinder, and in thick cylinder I will discuss the various assumption taken by Lamy's, and after that I will discuss statement taken by the Lamy's and how to compute the radial stress, hoop stress and longitudinal stress, and we will also see the distribution of longitudinal stress, hoop stress and longitudinal stress. So we are going to discuss about the thick cylinder. Analysis of thick cylinder was done by Lamy's. Analysis of thick cylinder is done by Lamy's theorem. Various assumptions taken by Lamy's. So assumptions, first assumption is metal is homogeneous, isotropic, and Hooke's law is valid. The plane section before fluid pressure remains even after fluid pressure. Means there is no bending. There is no bending. Each fiber of the metal is free to contract or expand independently. So these are the three assumptions taken by the Lamy's. Metal is homogeneous, isotropic and Hooke's law is valid. All these things are already discussed. What is homogeneous, what is isotropic and Hooke's law in the first unit. The plane section before fluid pressure remains plane even after fluid pressure, that is there is no effect of bending and each fiber of the metal is free to contract or expand independently. Statements taken by the Lamy's. Statements of due to internal fluid pressure enclosed cylinder
longitudinal stress are tensile and uniform across the thickness. Hoop stress are found to be varying hyperbolically from maximum at inner face to minimum at the outer face, and it is also tensile in nature. As I told you earlier, due to internal fluid pressure, the nature of the longitudinal stress and hoop stress will be in tensile, and the nature of radial stress is compressive. Radial stresses, which are compressive in nature, vary from maximum at the inner surface to zero at atmospheric pressure at the outer surface. So these are the three statements given by the labbies. Longitudinal stress are tensile in nature and uniform across the thickness. Hoop stress is found to be varying hyperbolically from maximum at the inner face to minimum at the outer face, and it is also tensile in nature. Radial stress, compressive in nature, vary from maximum at the inner surface to zero at the outer surface. So in the thin cylinder and thin sphere, we have assumed the value of radial stress is zero because the magnitude of radial stress is very less as compared to the longitudinal and hoop stress. But in analysis of thick cylinder, the magnitude of radial stress is also taken into account. So let us take a hollow internal radius is Ri and external radius is Ro. According to Lamy's theory, the expression of radial stress sigma x is equal to b by x square plus a, where a and b are the dimensional constant. The unit of a is newton per mm square and b is in newton. And the expression of as per Lamy's theory, expression of hoop stress, and similarly the expression of radial stress px is equal to b by x square minus a, where a and b are the Lamy's constant. X is the radial distance of fiber at which stress required. So A and B are the Lemmy's constant. Note the first point, A and B are dimensional constant, unit of A, Newton per mm square, and unit of B in Newton. Second point in the note, A and B can be computed using end condition for radial stresses. Third point is for internal fluid pressure, A and B both are positive. And the fourth point, for external fluid pressure, the value of A and B are negative. Value of B is much greater than A. And after that I am going to discuss the boundary / end condition for radial stress. So the expression of radial stress is what? Px is equal to B by x square minus A. So at x is equal to Ri, at the inner surface, Pri is equal to P. So what is the condition? P is equal to B by Ri square minus A. This is the first condition. And at outer surface, when x is equal to R naught, radial stress is equal to 0. So 0 is equal to B by R naught square minus A. With the help of equation first and second, solving first and second, we can get the value of A and B. So here A is equal to P into Ri square divided by R naught square minus Ri square. And similarly, the dimensional constant B is equal to P into R0 square into Ri square divided by R0 square minus Ri square, where A and B are the Lemmy's dimensional constant, P is the internal fluid pressure, R naught is the external radius, and Ri is the internal radius. Similarly, for hoop stress, we can write the expression of hoop stress is B by x square plus A. So this is the expression of hoop stress, B by x square plus A. And radial stress, Px, can also be written as B by x square minus A. So if I put B by x square value in expression of hoop stress, so the expression of hoop stress is Px plus 2A. So at x is equal to ri, sigma x is equal to sigma ri. So sigma ri is equal to pri plus 2a, or pri is equal to p, and similarly at x is equal to r0, sigma x is equal to sigma r0. So sigma r0 is equal to 0 plus 2a, so the value is 2a. So if I draw the distribution of radial stress and hoop stress, so let us take, this is the internal fluid pressure P and this is the center. This radius is Ri and this one is R0. So Lamy's statement, at the inner surface the value of hoop stress is maximum. The value of hoop stress is maximum and the maximum value is P plus 2A and the nature is hyperbolic. And this value is 2A. This is the nature of hoop stress hyperbolically. And that at the outer surface, similarly, if I draw the distribution of radial stress, so at the inner surface the value is radial stress maximum and it is 0 at the outer surface. So this is the nature and once again it is hyperbolic and this is the distribution of radial stress. Here positive is the tensile and negative is the compressive I have taken. Similarly, the expression of longitudinal stress can also be computed. This is the magnitude of longitudinal stress, internal fluid pressure P, internal diameter and external diameter DL. So if I draw by putting DI is equal to 2 times RI and D0 is equal to 2 times R0. For the above free body diagram, bursting force is equal to internal fluid pressure into pi into Ri square and resisting force sigma L into pi into R0 square minus Ri square. So if I equate by static equilibrium, according to static equilibrium, bursting force is equal to resisting force. And the bursting force is pi P into pi Ri square is equal to sigma L into pi into R0 square minus Ri square. So the expression of longitudinal stress is P into Ri square divided by R0 square minus Ri square. And we have seen this is the expression of Lamy's constant A. and this value is constant throughout the thickness. This is the problem on the thick cylinder. The internal and external diameter of a thick hollow cylinder are 80 mm and 120 mm respectively. It is subjected to an external pressure of 40 Newton per mm square and internal pressure of 120 Newton per mm square. We have to compute the circumferential stress, that is also called hoop stress or meridional stress, at the external and internal surface, and we have to also compute the radial and circumferential stresses at the mean radius. Mean radius means 40 plus 60 by 2, and at that point we have to compute the circumferential and radial stress. So the expression of radial stress Px according to Lamy's theory, that is Px is equal to B by x square minus A. Given data, Ri is equal to 80 by 2, that is 40 mm, and R naught is equal to 120 by 2, that is 60 mm, and the radial stress at 40 mm and 60 mm is given. At x is equal to Ri is equal to 40 mm, Px is equal to 120 Newton per mm square. At x is equal to R naught is equal to 60 mm, Px is equal to P R naught is equal to 40 Newton per mm square. This is given. So according to Lamy's theory, Px is equal to B by x square minus A. So when x is equal to 40, 120 Newton is equal to B by 40 square minus A. This is our equation number first. And when x is equal to 60, 40 is equal to B by 60 square minus A. And this is the equation number two. By solving equation first and second, we get value of A is equal to 24 and B is equal to 230400. Once we have computed the value of A and B according to Lamy's theory, expression of hoop stress sigma x is equal to B by x square plus A. So we have to compute the hoop stress at the inner and outer surface. So at x is equal to Ri is equal to 40 mm, we have to compute the sigma Ri is equal to B by x square 230400 divided by 40 square plus A is 24. So it is coming 168 Newton per mm square. And similarly, at x is equal to R naught is equal to 60 mm, sigma R naught is equal to B by x square. So 230400 divided by 60 whole square plus 24. So it is coming 88 Newton per mm square. So circumferential or meridional or hoop stress is computed at the inner and outer surface, that is 168 Newton per mm square and 88 Newton per mm square. Similarly, same thing we have to compute at the mean radius. So at mean radius, that is RM is equal to 40 plus 60 by 2. That is at 50 mm, we have to compute the radial stress. So the expression of radial stress, Px is equal to P at x is equal to 50 mm is equal to B by x square minus A. So 230400 divided by 50 square minus A. So it is coming 68.16 Newton per m square. And similarly, circumferential stress sigma x is equal to sigma at x is equal to 50 mm is equal to 230400 divided by 50 square plus 24. So it is 116.16 Newton per mm square. A thick cylinder of 0.5 meter external diameter and 0.4 meter internal diameter is subjected to internal and external pressure. If internal pressure is 25 meganewton per meter square and the hoop stress at the inside of the cylinder is 45 meganewton per meter square and the nature is tensile, so we have to compute the value of external pressure. So once again, according to Lamy's theory, hoop stress sigma x is equal to B by x square plus A, and the radial stress Px is equal to B by x square minus A, and this is the hoop stress. According to the question, if the internal pressure is 25 meganewton per square and hoop stress, when the radial stress is 25, B by 0.2 minus A, and similarly, hoop stress is 45 meganewton per meter square at inside, so B by 0.2 square plus A. So this is equation number 1 and 2. Solving 1 and 2, we get the Lamy's constant A is equal to 10 and B is equal to 1.4. So we have to compute the external pressure. So Px is equal to B by x square minus A. So external pressure PR0 is equal to B by R0 square minus A. And the value of B is 1.4 divided by 0.25 whole square minus A is 10. So it is coming 12.4 mega Newton per meter square.
So dear student, today I have discussed about the thick cylinder, and in thick cylinder I have discussed the theory given by the Lamy's theory, and according to Lamy's theory, the various assumptions taken by the Lamy's I have discussed, and after that statements given by the Lamy's, that is also discussed, and after that Lamy's given the expression of longitudinal stress, radial stress and hoop stress. So the expression of radial stress is B by x square minus A, and the expression of hoop stress is B by x square plus A, where A and B are the Lamy's dimensional constant, and the dimension of A is Newton per mm square, or dimension of B is in Newton. So with the applying end condition for the radial stress, these two Lamy's constant can be computed. Once we have computed these two Lamy's constant, then we can compute the value of hoop stress at inside and outside. So Lamy's concluded that the distribution of hoop stress as well as radial stress is hyperbolically, and the magnitude is maximum at the inner surface and minimum at the outer surface for the hoop stress, and for the radial stress, magnitude of maximum radial stress occurs at the inner surface and it is zero at the outer surface. And after that we have computed the value of expression of longitudinal stress, and after that I have taken two questions which are based on the Lamy's theory. So take care of your health and happy learning.